Howdy all, Michael and Fireman here, and welcome back to Season 2 of the Conelanders Assetto Corsa Racing League. This is Week 2, and we're at the Silverstone International Raceway Park thingy, and for the feature race. Now, the feature race, there's no practice, there's no qualifying, we just hop right on the track. The grid is set by the finishing positions in the two previous heat races. If you didn't see my heat race, I was at heat race number 1. Make sure you go back and check that out. That came out yesterday. I finished 8th in that, which is going to have me starting in, I believe, 16th, I think, out of 17 or 18. So, starting at the back of the pack, there I am, number 16. So, got a lot of work to do. But let's get on with the race, shall we?
I forgot the fuel estimate.
And here we are. Like I said, no qualifying, no practice, straight to the grid. So you got to make sure you got your setup. You got Rebel set up again. Thank you, Mr. Rebel, for giving me your setup. Make sure I had enough fuel. I just filled it up. We got 20 laps at this place. One fuel run lasts about 12 laps or something like that. I don't know. I don't know. That's not something that I really paid attention to. Because that's just not something
I just
that I do.
I have no idea where the pit entrance is.
It's on the last straightaway on the right.
Yeah, it's on the right. Yeah, right before you get to the chicane.
Okay, thank you.
And if you didn't catch that, I just told the guys I have no idea how to get into the pits at this place. Zero clue because we didn't.
And then you.
Well, it's not something that we practiced. We didn't have to pit in the heat races, so I didn't know where the pit lane was. I've never been to this racetrack before. So the guys were nice enough to let me know that it's right there at the right before the start of the chicane.
The pit lane is quite tight.
And they're giving me advice. Don't go too fast.
Last chicane, and then you cut across the track, right?
Yes. You can't miss it. Like, you just go to the right, and it's a solid pit road into the pit road.
Good luck.
Yes, thank you,
Coach. Good
luck, everybody.
We'll see.
Good luck.
So now we're just waiting for the start. With there not being any practice or anything, this is a green track.
Go on, because you're in second now. I'm behind you, not Sharky.
That sounds like a threat.
Savage.
So we've got Mr. Magnet OS up there in front of us. He's the one. He's the guy that again, if you didn't catch my heat race, go back and watch that. We had a tremendous finish between me and Mr. Magnet OS there up in front of us. Go check that out. And then over there on the left, we got NCWG4. And then me, and then Marzen on my behind me on the left, and Rotor X directly behind me.
Yes, get out.
Are we there? Yes, get out.
Yay, we are.
Let's go.
All right, here we go. Here's the lights. And again, starts are not my forte, so we'll see how this goes. Lights are dropping. Here we go. For my this is my first feature. My first feature race of season 2. First turn, I'm clear. I'm on the inside. Oh, geez. Magnet, look out. Okay, had to let off a little bit. All right, doing fine. Got somebody coming up on my inside now. Who was that? Marzen. How the heck did Marzen get up here? What in the world? All right, well, slow down. Make sure. Look out, that guy behind me.
Leg.
Rotor.
Oh, Sharky.
Oh, who's that on the left? Sharky. Sharky, what are you doing over there, Sharky? Again? Oh, let's give him some room. Let him get back on the track.
Ow.
And he's on my outside, so I gotta. Oh, look out! Oh God! Oh no! Oh, I got him a little bit. Doing fine. But then it slowed me down through the straightaway. And if you look on both sides of me,
I was inside of you.
Where am I supposed to go?
I tried to correct you, and it was
zoom. It's like a reverse parting of the Red Sea there. Those two guys made tremendous moves around me and NCW. Yes. That was amazing to watch. So, yeah. Sharky and Rotor X. Pats us both on the straightaway. That was great. That was awesome to watch. So here we go. Finish up the first lap. Get a inside loud on ACW. Make sure we don't push out and run into them. My braking points, my turn ins, they're not working. Why are they not working? I don't understand. At this point, I'm still like, okay, maybe it's because my tires are cold. My tires are cold. All right, fine. Turn in a little bit. A little early. Okay, fine. Wait, what am I doing way out here? Get back on the track. Slowed me down. I never lifted, but it still slowed me down. So, all right, I'll slow down for this one. Slow down a little bit too much there. I probably could have gone a little faster. And of course, Magnet OS right behind us yet again.
I believe some.
Now, I'm taking all these turns like I took them all through practice and all through the heat race. And they're not working as well as they were working before. Again, I couldn't figure it out. I had no idea what was going on.
Thank you, Cole.
Crap.
So now we're in, after the first lap and a half, we're in 14th, started in, 16th, so we picked up two spots. Whoop, look out, guys. There's two more spots. Up to 12th, I'm sorry, up to 12th. I'm okay with that.
There was Cone on my right.
Right, oh, did you not know he was there?
I'm sorry about a head up, so I didn't know what to do.
And again, my turn-ins, my braking points aren't working. Come here. Oh, holy moose. So now I'm all the way up to 11th. We're two laps in, starting a third lap. I'm up to 11th, and I got a lot of fast guys behind me. All of those guys are way faster than I am. So I'm pushing. I'm like, okay, I need some good laps. I want to keep those guys behind me as long as I can. I know that they're probably going to catch up to me and pass me, and that's fine. But I want to, the longer I can stay up ahead of them, the less may be able to pass me later. So I'm trying.
Keep it that way.
And I'm all over the place. All over the place. And I can't figure out why. Those guys up front are talking about Sharky trying to catch it up to him. Holy Moose making a move on Magnet back there. And I go a little wide here. I'm like, okay, I'm doing all right. I'm doing fine. Doing okay. What? No. No. That was actually me in the race saying that. So I lose three positions. You get out there on that green stuff, that AstroTurf, and you can just forget it, man. You're done if you're not careful. But again, I'm not understanding at this point. I'm not understanding why I was out there, because I was able to take that turn a lot faster than that in practice. So, and I'm looking over my tires and I'm like, okay, well, blue and green. What does that mean? Green is supposed to be good, right? Blue is probably cold. Whoops. Hee-hee. Oops. So I'm thinking it's just my tires aren't warm. You know, it doesn't register to me that this is a green track. There is no grip on this track because we didn't do any practice on this track. We didn't do any qualifying on this track. Cone started up the server. There we go. Wide again. Dadgummit.
That's something even more terrifying.
Cone started up the server. We got on it and we started racing. And the way he has the heats set up is you have practice and qualifying, and all of the rubber that's laid down during those practice and qualifying stays on the track for the race. However, it does not stay on the track for the feature. The feature is basically wiped clean. It's like it's a brand new day almost. So it's like it's wiped clean and you got to start from scratch. Spooky Squid, Spooky with the fastest lap. Good job, Spooky.
Squid with the fastest lap.
I don't know what happened.
You went really fast. That's what happened. Good job, Spooky. Now, having said all that, this is my best lap so far. A 125.11.
I don't think anybody pit.
Starting to get the feel for the car again.
Come on, Gunsis. Gotta catch him.
Starting to make turns a little bit better. Starting to feel better about the car. That turn got me most of the day. That's when I just realized that
that's why I'm having so much trouble.
Yeah, I just realized about the track conditions being green and slick. That's why I was having so much trouble. And once that dawned on me, once it registered in my head, I was like, okay, well now I have to slow down a little bit more, a little bit earlier, let off the gas a little bit earlier, and do better.
Close to you.
But I'm still nervous.
See a yellow flag up there? Oh, am I going to be able to catch somebody? Nope. No. Still green. Still green, though. On my Delta. Doing all right.
Don't mind me. Just catch Meister.
Yeah, I'm back in 14th. I was up in 11th.
Damn it.
Not a good chicane. Not a good club corner chicane, whatever it's called. So, of course, my Delta starts going back down, and yeah, whatever. So, I'm in 14th. I'm like, okay. I'm okay with 14th for right now. We're only six laps in. I got plenty of time to try to catch up with people. There's going to be pit stops, and then I think pit stops. Huh? When am I going to pit? What am I going to do? I don't have a clue. It's like, do I go crazy until I run out? I'm almost out of fuel. Or do I pit early? Well, if I pit early,
I don't want to sacrifice myself.
That was funny, by the way.
One of them gets a gun, the other gets a bullet. Just from the pressure.
That was Maestro talking about trying to slow up all the fast guys that are behind us, because apparently Cone Dodger had some trouble, and we saw Sharky having some trouble. So there was a lot of fast guys in the mid pack trying to fight their way back through, and that's what Maestro and Spooky and Gunsis are all talking about.
I had a lap before, so he'd already lost it.
Trying to hold those guys up, so hold the fast guys up so they don't catch up with them near as much. There we go, fastest lap so far, 119.560, pretty good for me anyway. Starting to get the feel of the car now.
Squid, no.
This is where the track goes. It's fine.
Apparently Squid went off a little bit.
We will remember you.
Lies.
Got the curb a little bit. Now, in front of us, we got 25 Rotor-X and GT Cooper. All of those guys were faster than me in the heats, I believe. I know 25 was. GT Cooper, pretty sure. Yeah, he finished in fifth. In our heat, Rotor X. Now he was behind us, but he's traditionally been faster than us throughout most of season one. We've been pretty even, but he's usually gotten a little bit ahead. But they're all together. They're all together. So they're all racing for position. I'm by myself, and like I talked about in my heat race when I was back and forth with Nihon Tiger, when you're racing for position like that, you're slower than somebody who's running by themselves. So those guys are getting woed up, and I'm charging. Hard charger. Well, I say hard charger, I mean, you know, it's another 120, but still, I'm coming. By golly. I'm getting closer. I can see their cars are getting bigger in my little screen up there. Oh no, that was a 119. Now again, Cooper talked about he had no practice. He had no practice in this car before this, you know, basically until right before the heat race. So he was struggling a little bit, plus with the green track, he was struggling a little bit. So I was able to catch up with these guys, get a wonderful run right here, get a great run on Mr. Cooper. Don't even have to draft him, really. Pull up beside him. I hope he sees me.
Oh, hi there.
Hello.
There you saw me. He's still on my inside, so I got to give him some room. And overcooked it into that turn. And I remember what happened in the second lap, so I wanted to make sure I stay off that green stuff. And he was able to get the spot back, just like me and Nihon, back and forth. But I've got the inside here. We'll just let him have it. We'll let him go. We'll catch him on the next lap. Now, again, Jim Knight behind us, he didn't have any, he wasn't racing with anybody, so now that me and Cooper are racing, he is caught up with us. Get another run on Cooper here.
No.
Decide to let it go.
You should slow hello. Down and take him out.
I think that was Jim saying hello from behind us. Cooper goes a little wide. I pushed it a little hard into that turn. Made up some time on him. Good turn here. I'll get him.
I didn't have enough.
There it is. There's a good turn. He had a better turn. Wasn't as good as I had hoped it was. So now I'm trying to draft off of Cooper, and Jim Knight is trying to draft off of me. Jim Knight is closer to me than I am to Cooper, so he gets a better draft. He pulls up beside me. Oh, he backed off. He backed off. Okay. All right. Doing fine. Good, good, good. Now, that turn right there was probably the best that I took that turn the entire time. And I was like, holy crap. Now, I didn't see what happened to Jim. I don't know if he got squirrely and loose. I know that I didn't just make up 5 seconds on him because of that one turn. But that turn was the best way I took that turn the entire weekend.
That was a nice save. A couple of them.
Too many.
That's Cooper asking if he was putting on a show for me. That turn, that was the best I took that turn all weekend, and I tried to duplicate that every other lap henceforth. And well, let's see how that turns out. So now 25 is caught up with Rotor X, and they're slowing down, allowing me and Cooper to catch up. Cooper gets a little squirrely again, but saves it again. Good job, Cooper. Doing a great job for somebody who had never driven this car before. Air quotes. I'm just kidding, Cooper. You're doing a great job.
That was close.
Now, again, Jim Knight, I didn't see what happened to him. See, here I am trying to duplicate that turn again. I was like, well, screw it. It didn't work out. But, I don't know what happened to Jim. Again, I didn't look up. Those guys are going into the pits, so I'm going to take their spots. And, again, I'm trying to think, well, when am I going to go into the pits? We're halfway through. I got enough fuel, but when do I go? Because I don't know how much fuel to put in afterward. Anyway, Jim Knight, I don't know what happened to him. Like, he was right behind us, and then the next time I looked up, he was 5 seconds behind us. I'm assuming that he got loose, almost spun out, saved it. Yeah. So now we're tracking down 25. Missed that apex. Bigger than hell. Yeah, Georgia behind us just coming out of the pits.
Plug in.
Too slow, too slow.
Yeah.
And then I look in front of 25 over there on my real-time monitor. I look at 25 and I'm like, Nihon! That's Nihon Tiger! I could race with him. I know I could race with him. I did it all last race, all day yesterday. I could do this. All I gotta do is catch him.
I'm having to shoe sleeve like a madman.
Squid, please.
Marzen having some trouble again back there in the back.
That might just be me.
I think I was referring to you.
Yeah.
Cupid.
Yeah.
Not bad on that turn. Could have been a lot better. But here I decided to go into the pits, and I'm like, okay, halfway through the race. I know I can make it the rest of the race if I completely fuel up my tank. And again, I'm thinking about all this stuff, along with all the stuff they talked about before the race. Don't screw up the entrance. Okay, doing fine. Oh, there's that spot they were talking about. All right, slow down. Don't miss your box. Make sure you shift down into first. I'm going way too slow.
That was rude.
And I get stopped, fuel up, and I'm thinking tires. How do I get? Do I do tires? How do I get tires? Where are the tires? Screw it. Let's just go. I was seriously thinking about getting new tires, but I couldn't figure out how to do it. Whoa, okay. There's a magnet coming in behind us. So I couldn't figure out with that little interface how to change the tires. And I decided that I had been sitting there too long. And so I was just like, screw it. We'll just do new fuel, same
coming
tires.
Out of the pits.
Let people know I'm coming out
did
of the
you
pits.
New tires, Gunsis?
No.
Yes, some people did, some people didn't.
Come here.
It's a, and that was, that was Cooper saying, somebody to race, come, you know, slow down so I can catch up to you.
Did you
and that's him behind us, going a little wide. And there he goes.
Never mind.
Never mind, he says. Some people took tires, some people didn't. It sounds like it's a personal preference thing. Some people feel better about getting new tires. Apparently, there's a, you know, if you get four new tires, it only adds about a second to your stop, maybe two. I don't know. I haven't ever done it, so I don't know. Go way too deep into this turn. Have to slow down way too much. I'm trying to usually trying to hit that turn around 75. I was at 67. not good. Not good. Allowed Cooper to catch up to us again, or get close to catching up to us again. And of course, I totally botched the club corners here. And again, I'm like, okay, well, no, bye, Cooper. Again, I'm thinking, okay, well,
come on, Cooper. It'd be nice if my chair would stop breaking.
So, again, I'm thinking, why, car? Why are you not turned? Rotor X coming out of the pits. Yeah, I get past him. Good job. I'm thinking, why are you not turning? Again, the car, the track should have rubber on it. I shouldn't be spinning. I shouldn't be sliding like this. And then I look and I'm like, okay, cold tires. All right, maybe cold tires have something to do with it. Who knows? Decent turn there. Decent. 13th. So we got GT Cooper behind us still. NCW G4 ahead of us. That's who we're trying to track down. Of course, they're 10 seconds ahead. And I look at that and I'm like, well, there's no way in the world I'm going to catch up 10 seconds. Make that 13 seconds. No way in the world I'm going to catch up 13 seconds. So I guess 13th place is the position I'm in. That's probably where I'm going to finish as long as I can hold off Mr. Cooper. And that's my plan at this point is to run a clean rest of the race, try to hold off GT Cooper, finish up in 13th. But of course, G2 Cooper has other ideas.
What did you do?
He made up over a half a second that lap.
One minute he was fine, the next minute he was in the grass.
Should have gone for the new tires.
And don't worry, I'll probably still be lost because I'm having to fuel save like an ass.
So now, we've got Jim Knight there ahead of us. And I think we had, Jim Knight was behind us before the pit stop. So my pit stop cost me at least one position so far. So far it's cost me at least one spot because Jim Knight was behind us by 5 seconds. And now he's 2 seconds ahead of us. So it's a 7 second difference there. Now I know that there's a pit configure app for Assetto Corsa, and I'll probably end up getting that. Once I figure out exactly how to install apps and how to access them and where to find them, I will more than likely put the pit configure app in there, especially with the changes that have been here over the past couple of with this season and what I'm sure will be coming into next season.
Did you take cars, Maestro?
Nope.
Again, varying opinions as to whether changing tires would help you or not. Finally got a good turn in there. Of course, Cooper had just as good a turn in. Now, this turn is one that got me in trouble a lot. So, I ended up slowing down way too much there. Yeah, tell Cooper.
Thank you for not hitting me. I didn't realize you got such a good run.
Oh, that's my fault if I hit you.
Yeah, he had a good run on the inside there, and I slowed down more than he did. So he had to get on the brakes even harder to avoid hitting me. And here I am trying to do that whole let off the gas and roll into that turn.
Agreed.
Instead of getting on the brakes hard. And it just kept not working out for me. Like I did it once.
Squid, no.
I felt great about it one
and
lap.
I'm throwing this away
and
I every time I hit
tried to do it the rest of the track or the rest of the race and I just couldn't. I had so much trouble with it.
I'm okay with that.
I'm not.
That was Cooper. He said that he keeps losing it every time he gets close to me. And I was like, I'm okay with that.
If I was doing a saves montage, I would be good with it.
Now, I feel like the tires are starting to come back to me a little bit here. Again, get a couple laps under them. I start warming up a little bit. I start being able to make my turns.
Sorry. That's cool.
Like I had in the past.
Oh, no.
I saw you coming, no harm done.
Got to start to pull a pretty good lead there. Made a much better turn there than Cooper did. Able to put a couple tenths. Could put a couple tenths on him. We got 4.5 laps to go. I'm still in 13th. This right there is where I decided. I was like, you know what? I'm just doing it like I've done it the whole time. And Cooper's gone. Hi, Cooper. And here he comes again.
That was the track.
Whoop. I shouldn't let off the brakes.
It actually wasn't that much slower.
That was an awful chicane. You know what was slower? Me and that chicane. Yes. Yes, I was. I let off the brakes. I should have just stayed on the brakes or, you know, I let completely off of the brakes. And that just screwed up my whole entry into that chicane. So. And that was Cooper talking about, I'm just going to settle for these 120s and quit trying for the 118s. And I'm thinking to myself, 118s? I hit a 118 all freaking weekend. And, of course, I make a mistake while I'm thinking that. And here he comes.
Stupid curb. I don't say no disaster.
Because I hit the curb. It screwed me up for that whole series. And screwed me up for the exit of this turn, or the exit of the turn before the hangar straight. And, of course, here he comes.
Did you pucker?
Is he going to make a move? Nah, looks like he's going to stay back. Oh. Went in too shallow trying to protect the inside.
I can tell your whole car turned pink.
Whoa, stay off of that stuff. Stay off of that stuff. Now he goes inside and he outbrakes me. And I see him over there. It's like, okay, fine. Fine. Go. Just go. Just leave me alone.
That could have been messy.
You're welcome. Yeah, I braked you late there. Sorry.
I think that was Nihon and Jim up there talking. So Cooper got past us, down to 14th, and it was one of those that, you know, we got three laps to go. He's faster than I am. I know that he's faster than me. He got by me. I'm gonna try to keep him behind me as long as I can. But once he gets positioned and I know that he's faster than me, you know, I'm not gonna wreck us trying to keep him behind us. You know, I'll just hope. As squirrely as he's been all weekend, he'll make a mistake and I'll be able to catch up to him.
But in the end, yeah, it didn't even matter.
Ba-dum-tsh. So now we got Rotor X behind us, Marzen and Magnet back there, way back. But Rotor X he's only 5 seconds back.
I bet.
And he's usually pretty quick, so I'm just. I'm just trying to make sure that I don't make another mistake like I did on that second lap that cost me three positions. I'm just trying to stay clean, stay focused, run 120s, high 119s. I'll be fine with it. I'll be fine with that. That'll keep me in this position. I don't think Rotor X is able to put up those kind of lap times. So I'll just ride out, finish in 14th. Got two laps to go.
Whoops.
Cut that just a hair. Didn't make up any time, so it's okay. Brakes, brakes, brakes. Missed it again. Dadgummit. That turn turned into my nightmare. This particular race.
Oh, sorry.
Now, Servatus had trouble with this turn. I was practicing with Servatus, and he spun on that turn. So many times, like I would come around the corner and see him sideways at that turn all the time. He did not like it. This track did not agree with him in this car, apparently. So now we've got GT Cooper, Servatus, and Neon Tiger, all three of them up there. And I'm thinking, okay, I know Cooper's all over the place because he's not used to this car. I know Servatus has had trouble with that one particular turn, and all three of these guys together. I might have a chance. There's a good chance that something is going to happen between those three, and I'll be able to take at least one spot. Just stay close. Just stay close. Something is bound to happen.
Come on, Jordan.
That's what I'm thinking
back.
Anyway.
Let's make a race.
No.
Please.
I will drop back as much as you did for me in the heat.
And this couple turns up here is where Servatus is having his trouble.
Oh, there it goes. There it goes.
And off they go. Two cars down, two positions up.
Good race.
Servatus and GT Cooper. Close finishes up front.
I had no idea if you got me or not.
I didn't. I was.
Got a half a lap to go. Got Nihon right behind Nihon Tiger again. Good job, Nihon Tiger. I'm glad you didn't get wrecked this time. Apparently, Spooky and Cone had a close race. Now,
I am so glad you won.
I probably could have gotten a lot closer to Nihon had I made that turn a little better. But I didn't make that turn any better. So I think with one more lap I could have caught him because I'd been catching him. I think with one more lap I could have caught him, but I don't think I'd have been able to do anything with it. And that's Cone talking to Sharky about. Sorry.
From my perspective, you were spinning off to the right, so I kept my car there.
But we finished up in 12th. But I think all it did was
lag bounce you way off.
So good.
I don't know where my pace came from. Where was that?
Spooky. That's Spooky talking right there. Spooky Squid. Fourth. Ended up in fourth. Good job, Spooky. I want to say he started 10th, maybe? There's me. There we go. Finished up in 12th after starting at 16th. Made up four positions. Not bad for a rookie. Not bad, I don't think.
Everyone's done.
And let's take a look at the final results here. Of course, we got Sharky. He ended up coming back and winning, even though he was down to, he dropped down to 12th or 13th, I think, at one time. The first lap, the first real turn. So good job, Sharky, for making your way back up. I'm glad you was able to make it back up to first, even though somebody punted you off in that first turn. But Sharky, Maestro, Cone Dodger, Spooky Squid, there you go. Seven positions. He picked up seven spots. Good job, Spooky. Gunsis Georgian also picked up seven spots. Holy Moose up there picked up two spots, got 2-5. Gemini, NCW, Nihon Tiger, and there I am in 12th place. Picked up four positions, 2 seconds behind Mr. Nihon Tiger that time. Not near as close as I was behind Magnet, obviously. But like I said, I think at least one or two more laps, I might could have got him. Might could have caught him, but probably not. So then we got GT Cooper, Rotor X, Servatus, Marzen, Magnet OS, and Disc Golfer. Poor Disc Golfer. He had to work right after the race, and we had some delays before the race started, and he was not going to have enough time to finish the race before he had to go to work. So he joined basically to make sure that he got his 1 point. But, he wasn't able to actually participate in the race. Poor guy. Felt bad for him. But there you go. There's the points. And again, like I said, in the future, I don't know if ballast is going to be added after this race. I know that it's added after the heat races. I don't think that it's added after the features. I don't know. I don't think so, but I don't know. Now let's take a look at the points results. All right, so here we go. Here is the Conelander Season 2 Championship points as they stand up to the minute. I just looked at this as I am editing and rendering this video. So there you go, right there. Number one, Cone Dodger. Good job, Cone Dodger. 2 points behind him is Sharky. 1 point behind Sharky is Maestro. And then you got Gunsis, George, and Servatus, Spooky Squid, Holy Moose, Gemini, 25, Disc Golfer. Poor guy had to get, couldn't finish up that feature there in Silverstone. D-Jump, Noah, Nihon, Marzen, and there I am, tied with Nihon and Marzen for what I would consider 16th place. 16th place. I like it. I like it a lot. And I would have been much higher had I been able to participate in the Monza feature, which was last weekend. But, you know, not bad. 8th and a 12th got me a total of however many points for those two races. I don't know. Who knows? Got a total of 21 for the first two. First 2 weeks, not bad. Not bad at all. Only 2 points behind Noah in 15th. And so, yeah, that's not bad, I don't think. Not bad at all. So let's now take a look at the rookie standings. Okay, so here we go. Here's the rookie standings at the end of week number 2. Got Holy Moose and Gym Knight way up in front along with 25. Holy Moose with 42 points, Gym Knight and 25 with 37 points. Good job, those three guys. And then the rest of us are basically trailing behind those three. D-Jump, Neon Tiger, Marzen, and me rounding out the top 8, 9. Then Mr. Bob, he did not participate in week 2 here, and he still is only 1 point behind us. Eesh, Mr. Bob must be pretty good. So there you go. There's the rookie championship so far. Holy Moose, Gym 9, 25. It looks like it's going to be a battle between those three unless some of us can get up there and do some work. Do some work. But I think, and again, down there at the bottom, poor Ollie Parsley. I don't know what's going on with Ollie. His computer screwed up that first race, and I don't know that he had it fixed before Silverstone or he just had something come up. I don't know. I'd like to see Ollie Parsley back. Ladies and gentlemen, make sure you hit him up on Twitter. Say, hey, man, what happened to Assetto Corsa? What happened, Ollie? Come on back. Come on back to us, Ollie. Come on back. But, yeah, there you go. There's the rookie championship for season 2. Halfway through the season. Now, if I understand it right, I will not be eligible for the rookie championship next year or next season because you can only have 2 seasons in the rookie class. So next season will be up to veterans. I don't know how accurate that is. I don't feel like a veteran, but, you know, whatever. It is what it is. But that's it. That's going to be the end of this episode. As always, I appreciate y'all for watching. If you have any questions or comments, make sure you leave them in the comments section below. If you enjoyed the video, leave a like, and I will see y'all next week for some race that I don't know what we're doing yet. But we'll see you next week.